A very good afternoon to lecturers, students, and my fellow friends. Today, I would like to talk something that I get inspired from Miss Christina's class this morning. Okay, just now Charlie talked about care. So today, I would like to share about love. When we talk about love, people will smile. Why? Because it's bringing something very beautiful in our life. Some people say that love is the relationship between girlfriend and boyfriend. In Tamil, they call it kadalan and kadali. I don't know whether my pronunciation is good. In Punjabi, they said it premika and premi. And then in Chinese, chingaida. And don't forget, in Malay, kekasihku or pujaanku. Then, some people say that love is about the nature. We protect the trees, we protect the rivers, we protect our world from global warming, and it's all about nature. Love our mother nature. But some people say that love is about your family, about your relative. Love your parents, your sibling, obey your parents, and become the best daughters or the best sons in your family, and let the responsibility fulfill in you, and get full flag in your study. That is love. But actually, love has a very wide meaning. Sometimes we cannot define what is love. It's very infinity. In my opinion, in my view, as long as there's no hate, that is love. Is it true? Yes. Alright. Okay. There's no hate, so that is love, right? Okay, have you ever heard these quotes? Maybe people have posted these quotes in Facebook many times, in Twitter. Even I might have posted these quotes last night. Okay. Please don't let the situation control over you, but you control the situation. Okay, let me modify a bit on this quote, so make it more beautiful to my topic today. We eliminate the word situation and we replace it with love. So the quote will be like this. Please don't let love control over you, but you control the love. You know why I promote these quotes today? Have you ever heard about the issue nowadays? Why people commit suicide for love? Why people get depressed because of love? Why people hurt themselves because of love? Because they misunderstood what is love and they get overwhelmed on it. So today we need to understand what it is actually. Okay, before that, have you ever watched a Sucker Punch movie? Yes. And I remember that the main actress was Emily Browning. Even though this movie is kind of old school movie, but I really love this movie. And for your information, I watched this movie more than 10 times. Because in this movie, it tells us that life is a matter of choice. From this movie, I learned a lot of things. For those who watch this movie, they will understand what I'm talking about. From this movie, I created a poem. I watched this movie when I was 4, whereas I was 16 years old. From this movie, I created a poem. Okay, this poem is like this. Each everyone of us who holds the power over the world we create, who crowns us with victory when we survive from the impossible, who honors those we love with the every life we live, who holds the key that can set us free, who is it? Who is it that does all things? Who is it? It is you. You have all the weapon you need. Now fight. In the Sucker Punch movie said these words. Now fight. You have all the weapon you need. Not meaning to say that you're going to war. This life is like a competition. So we have all the things in ourselves. So we have the courage. Same goes as love. Why I'm talking about love? Because when I saw in your detail, there's a lot of couple. Girlfriend and boyfriend. In food court and everywhere that I saw. Some of my friends, they said, this love influenced their study. Because sometimes they misunderstood what love. Love can give us courage, love can give us strength, but sometimes love can destroy you if you're too overwhelmed. So once again, I said, please don't let the love control you, but you control the love. Okay, from the poem itself just now, life is the matter of choice. It's in your hand. Unless people don't have hands, okay, life, it depends on you. Alright, so life is the matter of choice. If, okay, for example, I give a very simple example. If I say I want to move to the right, like this. So I move to the right. So it's my choice. If I say I want to This is what I wrote during Miss Christina's presentation just now. Okay, I want to tear. So it's tear. So your life is a matter of choice. If you said you want success in United, you will success. It's a matter you want or not, and you must give effort on it. That's it. So love is very powerful. Have you ever known the three main elements in our life? Love, faith, and hope. Among three of these, which one is the strongest? Love is the strongest. So love can give you strength, can give you courage, but sometimes it's just like fire. It can burn you. Alright, I would like to mention about the famous people. For example, have you ever known William Goldsmith, Alexander Dumas, Mother Teresa, Aristotle, Confucius, Lao Tzu, and also Woody Allen? These are very important people long time ago, right? They are very diligent and intelligent in their life, and they got their values. They also mention about love around them. For example, William Goldsmith said that he had mentioned this one. He said that, yeah, true love is the most great thing ever happened in my life unless cough drops. Maybe that time cough drop is a very bad thing happens in his life. But what he's trying to say that life is just like the wheel and we cycle the life. Sometimes we are at the top, sometimes we are at the bottom. So when we are at the top, so we must be grateful. When we are at the bottom, so we need to get up back. Okay, same goes in love. In any kind of relationship, no matter girlfriend, boyfriend, parents, nature, what? If we get clash on it, every relationship will clash somehow one day. It's no matter how you fix the relationship itself, right? So when you can fix the relationship, it will go long and lasting forever. That is how husband and wife, siblings and friends get forever. Okay, then, have you ever heard this quote? It's very interesting quote. I am a little pencil, and I was the handwriting of the God who is sending the love letter to the world. You know whose quote this one? It's Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa sent this one to one of the AIDS survivor. And then what she's trying to say that we come here to spread love, not to hate, not to murder each other. So even she herself said that love is important, not to destroy ourselves. Alright, I would like to share a song. Okay, this song is an Indonesian song. I would like to sing a bit. I hope you won't get annoyed. But this song brings a very powerful point on love. Maybe you will say this point is kind of dumb, but it's true. This song is sang by an Indonesian singer that is Chris Dayanti. It's entitled Menghitung Hari. Would you mind if I sing first verse and the chorus?
Dia masuk penyanyi pun.
Menghitung hari.
Suara masih
baik. Menghitung hari detik. Masa ku nanti apa dan ada. Jalan cerita yang masih panjang menghitung hari pergi saja cintaku pergi bilang saja pada semua biar semua tahu adanya diri. Sometimes giving up doesn't mean that you are too weak, but it's proof that you are strong enough to let go. Right? People say that giving up is not good, but sometimes it's, we are strong enough. So sometimes if you clash with your boyfriend or girlfriend, don't worry. A lot of flowers, a lot of fishes out there, more better than them. So remember, don't let get controlled by the love, but you control it.
10 nanti korang
So remember that. Remember this quote: "In peace, no war around us." Remember love. There's no hate. That is love. So may God bless us for today, tomorrow, and always. Peace, no war. Thank you.